is Jeff with Metalluminati. I'm here with Ezra from Allegaeon. What's up, dude?
Not much, man. How are you doing
today? I'm doing well.
Excellent. It's
we had like bagels and breakfast the other day.
It was excellent.
Good stuff. And so now headlining Barry Metal Fest.
Stoked on it.
Yeah, the crowd seems to be fucking pretty decent.
Yeah,
people are fucking having a blast. You guys just came out with your new record. Fucking talk about that a little bit.
Form Shifter came out May 8th. It was pretty sweet. It was our second full length. It was kind of anticipated. We haven't put a record out for 2 years since, so I don't know. It did well the first week, a lot better. It hit 3 Billboard charts, which is ridiculous for us. And it was
it's a fucking killer album.
Yeah, well, thank you. Mm-hmm. I don't know. We
I'm
were stoked
friend
on
and
it.
A fan.
Yeah, he's a good guy. He's a good guy. He always hooks us up whenever we're through.
I try, because metal's family, man. That's how it works.
Exactly.
You guys seem to do really well on your Facebook page. I mean, for the amount of people that you have that like follow you on Facebook, the content and interaction is pretty strong.
That's key, because we don't do too much touring. We had like drummer issues and just a lot of bullshit that happens.
Yep.
As far as just trying to find tours or agents.
Right.
Just all that stuff, management.
Yep.
But that's kind of like our key thing right now is just trying to talk to everybody individually, giving them a personal experience, let them know that, I mean, they're just humans, we're just humans, whatever the fuck. And, I mean, interaction's key. It's just like if I go to a show in Fort Collins or Denver or anywhere that we play, talk to people, and that's kind of the key thing.
How important do you feel touring is in the modern music era? I mean, you've been able to work with what you got, but I mean...
I think the best way to get your product in front of somebody is to actually put it in their face. And unfortunately, it's a little difficult to do so. We got Greg.
Hi, Greg.
Hey, friends.
But yeah, it's a little difficult to get out on the road. I mean, some bands have it a little easier where they can just get out there and do it. I mean, we all have jobs. We're trying not to screw ourselves over too much, but ultimately, like, that's how I feel about...
I have no clue what's touring. Going on.
Just touring.
Oh, touring.
Touring.
Yeah, the importance of touring.
Oh, exactly. The elusive tour.
The elusive.
We have not been able to grasp.
Yeah, we
love
to. Have
you had trouble with, like, touring agents, wrong amounts, bad people?
What it is it's...
Bad luck.
Bad luck. Okay. Yeah, yeah, not getting into the right hands, getting on the right bills, or any kind of tour offers, really. I mean, we had an agent, we had management, and just kind of fizzled out. Now we're just seeking new management, agents, anybody that's willing to help us out and believes in our product mm-hmm. as much as we do. You know?
Cool, man. So, what's the plan? I saw you guys got some shows locally, right?
Yeah, we have a New West Fest in August, and then we have another show, I think, in October in Denver for a radio station, I believe. And, I mean, we're just kind of keeping our eye out. We want to do a fall situation. That would be nice just to get on the road with some reputable bands. Maybe not just go out by ourselves, just get out there with some bands that we can hang with and have a good time with. And that share similarities with our music, but also, you know, maybe a little different. That way you can get a variety of people there, you know, mm-hmm. the more the merrier. It's always a good time.
Talking about that, both of you, you know, like, there's this genrefication of music that I always talk about, you know, like the split and genre this, genre that. I mean, in my opinion, it's like, if I like it, I like it. If I don't, I don't. I don't care what it's fucking called. You know what I mean? Like, but the split in fans has made it so much more difficult for metal all around.
Oh, yeah.
Because they're split into these like subgenres.
Well, I mean, we're guilty of it as much as anybody, you know? The trick is, too, you need to remember that everybody's just doing this what they like to do. And if you don't like it, well, just don't listen to it.
Right.
There's no need to run your mouth off. And that's one thing that I've never understood. You're always going to have YouTube trolls or whatever, but it's like, oh, you don't like it.
Troll on! Troll
it's like,
on!
It's not my. It's totally not my thing to just be like, man, these guys suck. What the fuck? What are they doing? It's like, oh, I don't like this. So why am I listening to it?
You know? Right. As far as the internet goes, everybody has a personality. But as far as like the whole subgenre, the cores, this chord, that,
thrash,
metal,
whatever,
edges, everything. Like, ultimately, I kind of feel that it's kind of fading away. Like, it was like a real popular thing to be very specific.
Mm-hmm.
Like, this is deathcore, this is metalcore, this is Ezra core.
Right.
But,
Applecore!
This is Chinatown coffee core. But ultimately, like...
Crustacean core.
Yeah, crustacean core. We really did just get this in Chinatown. Me and Corey went on a date.
Yeah, why is everything closed in Oakland?
Yeah.
Oh, why? Saturday night late? Because it's downtown. Downtown city on this side, you know?
Yeah, dude, we're just trying to get a cup of joe.
Or is it
No, it just closed down because it's like the weekend.
Oh.
Huh.
Oh.
But there is a fucking Roach Coach right there.
If you ever want to make $1 million, open a coffee shop that's open 24/7 in downtown Oakland.
There you go. That's Ezra's business tips for today. All right, man. Well, thank you so much, man, for taking the time.
Thanks for always taking care of us.
Of course, brother. Your family, dude. Always.
And Panda Express. Dude hooks us up on the road.
Oh, yeah!
When we get on the road.
Metalluminati, motherfuckers.
Hey.
Hey.